Hi, I'm Professor Farhad Hafezi from the ELZA Institute in Zurich, Switzerland. I'm part of the original Swiss group that introduced corneal cross-linking into ophthalmology 16 years ago. Today, I would like to show you something very exciting. I'm having my thumb here to keep patient confidentiality. See, this is a patient I have cross-linked almost 1 year ago. This is the state of the cornea with the keratoconus a few days ago, and this was before cross-linking. And when we put both images together, we see in green that the cornea did not only stabilize, it improved. The green means improvement over the cone. So this is a nice success. But in fact, what we measure here is how the form changes, the shape changes. But keratoconus is a mechanical problem. So in fact, if we could measure how stiff the cornea is before and how stiff it is after cross-linking, this would make more sense. But until now, we didn't really have the possibility, and now we do. I'm very pleased to see that we are among the first to have the new Oculus advanced display that allows us to measure this type of things. Now, the color images that you saw right before were from a pentacam, and as a keratoconus patient, you know these images. They show us the shape of the cornea before and after cross-linking, and you either see stabilization or even improvement. But in fact, keratoconus is a disease of the tissue. The tissue is too soft, and cross-linking makes it stiffer. Until now, we could not easily measure that, but now we can. This is the corvus from Oculus, and the corvus is a device that directly measures biomechanics. This is the patient's cornea before cross-linking. So a strong air puff makes an indentation of the cornea, and we can measure the deformation, how fast it deforms, how long it takes the cornea to get back, and how it behaves during the air puff. And now, for the very first time, we can plot this before and after. Now, look at this. This is quite amazing. The blue cornea is the cornea before cross-linking, and the red is the same cornea 1 year after cross-linking. And as you can see, the blue one deforms, goes further in, and the red one is stiffer, thus the deformation is not as strong. If you look at it again, the red one stays on top, the blue one goes further in. You can even see it with your own eyes. This is just beautiful to see, and then we have several indicators telling us, yes, indeed, the cornea got stiffer. It's a wonderful display, and it will help us a great deal in the clinical judgment whether or not cross-linking was successful. Farhad Hafezi from the ELZA Institute in Zurich, Switzerland.